Welcome back. In the previous video, we had seen that the standard TCP, this is the way it was adjusting its congestion window size. It was peaking to the high value. Then once it found congestion, it was dropping the congestion window to the window size of 1. It was getting back to the stop and wait. Okay, we saw it in the previous video. So in this video, what we'll do is we'll now move forward. We'll now focus on the TCP, the new Reno version. So we'll have the same network as it is. We just want to replace the TCP over here. It was the standard TCP. Now we want to use it as the new Reno. So for that, what we'll do is, let's get back to the simulation, Ubuntu. In fact, let's open the, or let's make a copy of the TCL file. We had made experiment 07 tcp.tcl, so let's copy it. Let's call it as experiment 07 tcp new Reno TCL. So the reason I'm doing this is we could have made the new Reno two ways. We could have in fact gone back to the scenario, build a new scenario, new wired scenario, and did everything from scratch as we had done in the previous case, the standard TCP. The other way is we'll just directly work on the TCL. Since we have the TCL here, we copied it. So I'm just showing you a shortcut over here. Let's open this experiment 07.tcp.newreno.tcl. In fact, what I suggest is if students are confident changing this TCL, only then you should adopt this particular approach. Because any, say, mistakes in the TCL will basically get us into lots of iterations of debugging, and it will waste our time. So this approach, let's take it only if you are comfortable or confident with the TCL. So I have taken this TCL. Now I want to rename all this TCP part with TCP new Reno. So for that, what I'll do is I'll just go to the gedit's find and replace function. I want to replace hyphen TCP with hyphen TCP underscore, or let's call it as hyphen new Reno, replace all of them. So it, you can see there it has found four places and it has replaced all those four places. In fact, even the congestion window data file that we are using, that also it has replaced. Okay, this is one change we did. Then what we'll have to do is everything is same apart from here. So now the agent is not just the standard TCP, it is standard TCP new Reno version. So I just type this. And rest all is fine. And one final check we need to do is the NAM file that will be executed. Okay, NAM file also has been renamed as hyphen NR. Good. So these are the two changes, few changes that we'll have to do. We save it. Let's get back to the terminal. NS experiment 07.tcp, sorry, hyphen TCP hyphen NR dot TCL. Let's see if everything good. So everything seems to be fine. It has compiled successfully. It has brought up the animation. Also see the animation. It has brought up the animation that we want for new Reno. So we play this now. Let's see what happens. So let's increase the step sizes. So we have traffic flowing. The packets coming up over here. Okay, we have some drops happening. But observe this. When the queue dropped off or the TCP pulled back, it didn't pull back so much where the link was free. In fact, link, we can see that it is always engaged. Something or the other is continuously going. So one side it is handling, this source is handling the that queue doesn't go beyond a certain limit. On the other side, it is reducing. Plus, it is also making sure that the link is being used effectively. So this further insight we'll get when we look at the congestion window or data file, or if we plot it. Okay, let's finish this animation. Let's stop it. We'll close this. Let's Yeah, this also let's quit. And then let's look at the congestion window data files that have been generated. Good. So this was generated from the previous experiment, standard TCP, and this has been generated from the current one. So we want to have a look at the current one only. So right now, if we do GNU plot and say MGAT underscore congestion window plot, right now it will pick up these two files and plot them. Like we can see that it has picked up those two files and plotted them. And they are like kind of overlapped on each other. If we want to focus on only one of them, that is this one, new Reno. So let's remove this. To remove this, what we'll have to do is we'll have to remove that file. So we'll have to remove this data file. That is basically experiment 07 TCP congestion window dot dat. Let's remove it, and then again we are doing a GNU plot. So now we can see the GNU plot, the script that we wrote, MGAT script. It has picked up only one file and it has plotted. And we can see here that how new Reno is behaving. Look at the new Reno. This is also is oscillating between 14, and observe this. It is not dropping to stop and wait. It was not dropping its window to 1 over here. Rather, it is kind of stopping at 7. So it is oscillating between pipelining 7 packets at a time versus 14 packets. It found a packet to be dropping. Immediately it is dropping and it is making its window size to 7. That's the reason it's kind of not kind of going to the other extreme of going to stop and wait. It is in fact pipelining only, but with 7 packets. That's how it is adopting to the link. Whenever congestion is there, immediately it drops back. And then it works for some time with 7, and then it slowly starts again adopting to the link so that the link is effectively utilized. This is how it is going through. Now with this mechanism, let's see what throughput the new Reno is getting. So to look at the throughput again, what you'll have to do, you'll have to run the awk, awk minus 1 minus f mgit underscore wired 05. And the trace file we need to give is experiment 07.tcp-nr.trace. So now observe this. This is the acknowledgement portion. We are not interested in it. We are interested in the TCP portion. So TCP observe that the main thing to observe here is the throughput that it has achieved. Look at the throughput. It has almost got the capacity of the link is 100 kbps, we know. And then it has got till 99. That means it is effectively used the link. The other things to observe is, okay, it sends 739 packets and all of them are delivered. So 100% delivery, reliable communication. Okay, good. So we got the throughput. Let's plot them as well. So while plotting, there are this ACKs also, data files for the ACKs also. Let's remove them off. Unnecessarily, they'll come in the plot as well. So let's say remove ACK, whichever file has ACK, and which are DAT files, remove them. So yes, we removed them off. We are left with only the TCP or the TCP throughput files, two files. So let's do a plot. We use GNU plot, MGAT. For throughput we use, let me run this again. Yeah, now we have got the throughput plots. Time axis, and this is the throughput, and this was for the previous standard version, and you can see the new Reno has slightly performed better than the standard TCP, and it's almost touching the capacity. You can see the capacity is 100 and it has gone till 99. That is the learning that we have. New Reno is performing better. It is able to adopt to the link better than the standard TCP. It's also avoiding the congestions. Okay, we'll stop here. And in the next video, let's focus on the Vegas. That's the last type of TCP.